So let's write this insert query to add data in our table of posts. So first of all, let's change all of these redirection to the same page of add new post. So add new post here, and then in the success message here, and in the error message here. Saving this one. Now you have to focus on this block from line 27 to line 34. So first SQL insert into, instead of category, we will insert in our table of posts. Let's confirm the spelling of this table name, that is posts in lower form. Then we will have couple of column. The first column is date and time. So putting date and time at the beginning. The next column is title. We already have title. Then we have category. So putting category at third. Then we have column of author. It's already there. Then we have column of image. So putting it here. Then we have column of post. So putting at the end here. So now we have to specify the named parameter for each column. So the first column will be date time. So putting it at the beginning here. Then we will have the title column for our post. So defining it here as an post title. As I told you before, it will be a dummy name, so you can put any type of text here. So post title will be second one, then the category. So we already have category name here. So then we have author, we have admin name here. Then we have image, so we will have image name. Then at last we will have our post. So I will call it post description. After that, we will prepare this whole SQL and then we will bind the value. We already bind this category name to this variable of category. So let's confirm this category variable. So scrolling down to the PHP, we put the category name inside category. The admin name will be admin. The date and time will be date and time variable. But let's do all of this in a complete write sequence according to our named parameter. So the date and time will be at the beginning. Although the order does not matter, but I think it will be easy for you to look if all of this in a sequence. So first one will be the date and time. Then we will have second STMT that will bind this post title. And we need colon here. Also we need colon at the beginning of date and time. So the variable that we need to put here will be post title, this variable. Then we will have category name. We already wrote that one, admin name. And then we will have our image name. So our image name is saved inside this variable of image. So this one on line 8. So we can mention simply this variable of image here. Then we have post description. So copying all of this and paste it here for post description. And the post description has the variable of post text. So putting that variable here. So now saving this one. Let's remove unnecessary lines from here. So after that, we will execute our whole statement, and then we will show the statement with a success message or error message. So if I save this one, and first let's refresh our page to load the new PHP. So I will say here first post and choosing my category to fitness. So selecting some image from my folder of downloads. So I will select this 3.jpg image. If I hover on this tab, you can see 3.jpg. And in the post description, I will put here something like, this is testing post. So if I click on this publish button, you can see I got this message, category with ID 1 added successfully. So I need to change this title. So let's change it to post with ID or something. So we added this one. So first let's check by clicking on first this table and then clicking on the browse tab. You can see the name of my image 3.jpg, the author name, the category fitness, text, date and time, and the post description. So if I open my uploads folder, so here is my uploads folder inside my CMS 4.2.1, but there is no image here at all. It's because we wrote all of this script to add the data in our database. And I told you earlier, we cannot save our whole image in our database. We can just simply save the name of our image that we did here. You can see the name of our image, 3.jpg. So in order to save your image, you have to save it to other directory. Here, if I can show you real quick, I have this variable of target on line 9, where we specified the location where we will save our image. But we have to move our image from its source to its destination. So this will be the destination of our image where we will save our image. But we have to use another function to pick our image from downloads folder and save it to this upload folder. So right inside this else block, right after executing this whole query, this whole one, I will have one simple PHP function of move underscore uploaded underscore file. And this function will take our image by using the super global of files. And our image has the name of image. And then we have to specify one more thing here. That will be TMP underscore name. Actually, whenever PHP will upload some file, it will give that file some temporary name. And it will be different than the actual file name. And PHP will only remember the file name with this constant of TMP underscore name. So inside this function of move uploaded file, I'm saying here to PHP, that by using the super global of files, take this image which has some temporary name given by you, given by PHP. So in the first argument, we will specify this one. And in the second argument, we have to specify the location. So we already wrote the location in form of a target variable here at the top on line 9. So it will take our whole image and put it in the target location. That's it. Now, if I save this script and first let's refresh our page. So adding second post, selecting some image, for example, this animation .jpg. And post of second, clicking publish button. You can see post with ID 2 added successfully. So here you can also see the second post name of our image, but we have to make sure whether we uploaded in the folder of uploads or not. So this is my uploads folder. It's still empty. So this uploads folder is empty. So we have to find out what's the error. So back to my editor. Here is this function move underscore uploaded underscore file. Then we specified the temporary name constant here, and then we have the target here. So we have to check whether this target is okay or not. So scrolling up here, I said go to this upload folder, and here we have uploads. So I have to add the S here because this folder name is uploads, not upload. Then we will have base name underscore files, image and name. So if I save this one and let's refresh our page, adding third post, this image of HTML5 CSS3.jpg post, title, post description will be third post dummy, publish, post edit successfully. Here you can see the third post, and let's check our upload folder. Congratulations, we finally made our script to upload the file in our directory of uploads, and here is this image. So this is how we enter our images. Now let me walk you through everything what I have done in this file of add new post. So it's very simple file. First, I grabbed every single field by super global of post, but for the image I use this super global of files that take our file that has the name of image, and I saved the whole image name inside this image variable. As I said, we cannot save our image directly in our database, we can just save the name of our image. Then we have this post text which we grabbed out of the field of post description. We have admin and date and time. We have these simple validation: if post title is empty, if length is less than 5 or greater than 999, we will show user some error. Otherwise, we will write this insert statement that will put all of our data in our table of posts. After that, we executed our query and move our uploaded file from its source destination, where PHP is holding that file in the super global of files, to the destination where we want to save that file, and that location is this uploads folder. Then we are showing the success message and error message. Now last comments for this lecture is, make sure that you add one additional argument inside your form, and that is adding this ink type to multi-part slash form dash data in order to process your images. And also we are putting our category dynamically, we are fetching all the categories from our table of category. So that's how we process images and data, and we save them in our database in PHP by using PDU.